This is optical profile projector. It works on principle of reflection of light. So in case of optical profile projector, what we have is we have a digital optical profile projector. But before that, let us go through the concept of optical profile projector. In optical profile projector, basically it works on principle of reflection of light. So what we have is we can keep a component on the glass table. This is a glass table available here. And if we keep a component, very small component, if I keep on the glass table, we get a magnified shadow of a component on the glass screen. So this is the glass table, and below this the light source is available. Light sources are available from bottom as well as from top. So two types of readings we can take. We can take readings with help of shadow, and we can take readings with help of surface also. Particularly here, if we look at the glass table, if I keep very small components like a screw, this is a very small screw, just see this, and if I keep a small screw over here, we get a magnified image of that screw. So just see, this is a magnified image of the screw. If I keep any other threaded portion like this, you will get a magnified image of that threaded portion. So we can keep very small components on this, and we can get a magnified images of the component. So for this purpose, in this particular case, we have used the lens of 10x. So 10x means if I keep a component having 10 mm diameter, it will be visible as 100 mm diameter on the glass screen. Apart from this, the glass screen is provided with some lines marked, which are very useful while we take the measurement. This can be used as the reference. And this glass table is having a knob over here, so this is for angle measurement. So you have to keep it for a reference like this. This is basically a digital profile projector. What we do have is we have a digital readout over here. So you can see this is for x axis, y axis, and this is for angular measurement. For this purpose, the instrument basically have the movement of glass table. That is, if I just rotate this particular knob, it is provided with linear scales which are available in CNC machines. So if I just rotate this, the x axis will move. It is available with a 1 micron discount or not 1 mm discount. And if I rotate this knob over here, you can see y axis will move. And if I rotate this knob, the angle will move. So three scales are available with this instrument, that is x axis, y axis, and we can measure the angular things. We can set it for zero by pressing these knobs. So this is a home position, that is 000, and we can start taking the measurement. So you need to keep a component at this glass table. Just closely look at this. This is a glass table and light source is below this. So when we start a light, the shadow is available on the glass screen. And with help of this shadow and this digital readout, we can carry out many types of measurement with this optical profile. Going to measure various thread parameters for this image, I have kept a thread gauge on the glass table with some dimensions, and the image of this or shadow of this is available on the glass screen. This is basically a magnified shadow if you look at this. So I can measure pitch of thread, which is the distance between two successive roots or two successive crests. I can measure major diameter, which is outside diameter. I can measure minor diameter, which is which takes roots with it. So let us start with measurement of pitch. What I will do first is I will set the screen to the reference line at one of the root. So I have set it for this particular root, and pitch is nothing but distance from this to this point. So at this, what you have to do is you have to set this x for 0. So I have set it for 0 now, and then you have to move this table so that it touches to the next root point. So here comes the next root. So what I have done, I have moved the shadow from this to this point. So this becomes a pitch. So if you observe here, you can see that x has moved to 1.250 distance. So this is the pitch of this thread. If you look at the thread gauge, in the specification of thread, the pitch is mentioned, 1.25 mm. So this is also giving us a 1.25 mm reading. So this instrument is having very high accuracy with its scale. Now I will measure outside, that is major diameter of this thread. Outside diameter means from this up to this point. So what I should do first is I should bring all the crest point in line with the horizontal line like this, and after that I will set Y for 0. So you just press Y button here, it will become 0, and then I will move this knob so that all the crest point at this position will come in line with the reference line. So if I move it like this, so here they are touching the all crest points. So at this the reading is 10.018 mm. So it indicates that this outside diameter is, or major diameter is 10.018 mm. Similarly, to check minor diameter, what I need to do is I will set all the root points in touch with the reference line, then I will set this for 0 Y, and then I will again move this to all root points at upper side. So here it is giving me reading 8.470. It is giving minus because we have moved the scale in that particular manner. So if I just neglect this negative sign, the minor diameter is 8.470. So this is how we can use this profile projector to check pitch, major diameter and minor diameter of thread. This profile projector can be used for many features, like we can check thread parameters, we can check very small components. Similarly, we can check some parameters with help of vernier which are not possible to measure. For example, this diameter, this is a small diameter, so there might be a possibility that vernier internal jaws will not go inside this. So we can measure this diameter with help of this profile projector. So if I keep this component at this, and the shadow is available on the screen now. So what I need to do is I need to measure this diameter. To measure a diameter on the display, a symbol with circle is available here, this one. If you closely look, this is the symbol with the circle. So what you need to do is you need to press this first. Now it will display X, Y and Q, and it will display the circle of symbol. Now on the diameter, what you have to do is you have to locate number of points, because circle, basically if we have to define circle, we need more than 3 points. So to define these points, what you have to do, you have to move this to touch one of the point on the periphery. So let us say this is first point, then you have to press enter at this, it will indicate first point. Then again I will move so that it will touch second point. So let us say this is point number 2 on the periphery. Again I will press enter here, it will indicate point number 2. Don't look at this reading, the points are very important, their coordinates. Then I will move this. Now I will move it vertically to take third point. So this is point number 3 on the periphery. I am not at all measuring anything, I am just locating the points and I am pressing enter. So I will press enter here, this is point number 3, and finally I will move it to measure one more point to define a circle clearly and to have an accurate reading. So this is point number 4. So when I press enter now, what I have done now, I have recorded 4 points on the periphery of this circle. I have recorded 4 points on periphery of this circle. One point here, one point here, one point here, and fourth point here. When I press finish here, this will give me the value of diameter. 9.558 mm is the diameter of this particular circle. So this is how it can be used for measurement of diameters, even for measurement of radius, in which the integrate radius are there, where we cannot locate it with help of vernier. So if I just locate with 3 points, it can easily give me the diameter. So this is very useful instrument for measurement of different features.